What is going on, friends? We are back with more World Cup. We got the Thorn playing for Team Europe, Alcons playing for Latin America. Just so you guys know, this is gonna be live. I'm just reiterating over this, so no worries. You're gonna have your smoke just chat. This is gonna be like a live battle. This isn't a replay. But so yeah, I'm just gonna talk about the teams because I was too late and I missed the team preview and I had to run do something. So I think it's pretty interesting to see they both have a Latias. It's probably going to be Choice Scarf on both sides with Healing Wish, potential Defog for Hazard Control. The Thorn is probably going to be packing a Mega Tyranitar, a Stealth Rock, Heatran, which is probably a Taunt and Toxic. Alcons is going to be packing, I assume, Subtoxic Heatran and Offensive Z-Move Landorus with Stealth Rocks. His other Z-Move options would be a Tapu Koko. That's just what I'm thinking. I haven't seen the game at all. I just left the game when I recorded this. I left the room. And the Thorn has a Zapdos, which could be Z-Move user, or it could also be a Z-Move Tapu Bulu. And I guess the is probably going to be Spadef to check Ash Greninja, or Greninja in general, to check Magearna. And yeah, we'll see when the... He let off his Gastrodon turn 1, switched onto Zapdos, and we saw that the Landorus U-turned out. So this makes me think that the Landorus is maybe defensive Stealth Rock. So at first I was thinking this is potentially a Z-move Landorus, but Landorus showing U-turn makes me think that it's probably Z-move Tapu Koko. So yeah, we will just start from here. So U-turn out on the Zapdos, it is 13%, which is a lot. So this is either offensive Choice Scarf Landorus, because the Zapdos is defensive because it has lefties. I mean, it can still be offensive with lefties. Yeah, it's not confirmed yet. It can still be offensive Zapdos. We do see this pressure ability, so this could potentially be a Defog Zapdos. He goes out on the Tapu Koko. Z-move might blow this away if it has Z-move. The Thorn will probably just go out into his Gastrodon here. Alcons could also go for Taunt, because the Thorn might go for a Roost here, predicting a Z-move. I could also see a Nature's Madness coming out. I don't know if I have talked about the score so far. The score should be 1-0 for Team Europe before this game started. The Thorn playing for Team Europe, I think I mentioned that, yeah. Alcons playing for Latin America. He does just go for Nature's Madness, as the Zapdos just roosted off. So I think he's gonna go for Taunt here. So if I'm the Thorn, I would probably just go hard into Gastrodon, but he goes hard into Tapu Bulu. So he gets up to Grassy Terrain. Unless the Koko has Brave, but it can't kill the Tapu Bulu, so he turns out into probably Landorus or... yeah, I mean, I set the play when the Landorus came out, but it was his best switching because he wasn't risking. Latios can't really do much back to Tapu Bulu, and Heatran would potentially die to a superpower there, so he wasn't risking that. We do see that the Landorus packs leftovers, takes not that much damage from Horn Leech. Yeah, the annoying thing about this is I can't really run calcs when I'm recording over an old video. When I'm re-narrating this, basically. So I'm not sure if this is Adamant Tapu Bulu, but I think it looks like Adamant potentially. If the Landorus is heavily invested in defense, which is what I'm thinking, this is Alcons check for stuff like Zygarde. So I think this has to be like plus defense nature. He's probably just gonna U-turn here. Yeah, he was expecting like a SD or something like that, because at -1 I don't think the Bulu could kill the Landorus. It probably could have even left a Z-move from that range. He goes out in the Heatran, this is screaming that it's Toxic Heatran. And yeah, on the Thorn side, I'm really liking the core of, like, he has Tapu Bulu to give his Heatran and his Gastrodon more recovery. And he does get a Discharge Powerful Power, that sucks. He also has the Grassy Terrain to help with his Tyranitar, so it's not weak to EQ anymore. But we do see it's a bulky turn, because the Discharge didn't do that much. And he has lefties and Grassy Terrain to heal up a bit more. Actually, I thought for a second that the Discharge only did 18% because I was looking away. I did not factor in the Grassy Terrain plus leftovers. So like 31 is actually like a good amount compared to 18%. Because I was looking at the Thorn's team and not at the Heatran. So he's just going for the Paras here. There is the Toxic that was about to be expected. I mean, the Thorn didn't have a good Toxic switching besides his own Heatran. So that might confirm that the Thorn Citroen does not have Earth power, because if the Thorn Citroen has Earth power, he might have gone to it there. So I'm thinking he might be Stealth Rock's Taunt Toxic Lava Plume Heatran without Earth power. If he goes on the top of Kogu, I probably just predicting a discharge or a switch in the I don't know if he predicted the switch in Heatran, but he probably just predicted a discharge. And yeah, if he has Z move, he can go for that here. I would always go hard into Gastrodon here if I'm the Thorn. I guess he can just go for Nature's Madness. And then if you do Thorn, he goes for Taunt, breaking the Stealthrox. And he just goes hard for Magma Storm. Yeah, I don't think I would have gone for Taunt there. Like, Magma Storm. Elkhorn's best switch into Magma Storm was obviously his own Heatran. Because Greninja takes a good amount from that. He also could have gone Greninja. Like, Latios isn't really a switch into that, because Latios isn't doing much back to Heatran. But yeah, he goes on to Greninja this time. The Thorn's Heatran is well trained, it's hitting his Magma Storms. So Greninja is basically at almost half now. I'm thinking this is not Scarf Greninja. He goes for Spikes, so he's Ashgren. We don't see Protean. So unless he's wild and he's running a Torrent Greninja, he's obviously Battle Bond. He does get up two Spikes, so potentially forcing the Thorn to defog later on, as Spikes do hit four of his members. Gastrodon can go for Scald here or for another Toxic, but I think Scald is overall a fine play. Greninja's locked into Spikes. He might even get up all three layers, but I'm not sure if it's worth it for all counts, because he might die to Earth Power or Earthquake if he stays and goes for another Spike. So he just goes on the Latios. Heatran was a nice play there, because you know the Greninja's locked into Spikes if it stays in, and if he's switching, he wasn't going out into something like Landorus on a Gastrodon. He was either going into Lati or maybe into what else? Yeah, Lati was like pretty likely to come out there, so that makes a lot of sense by the Thorn. He can throw up his rocks here, or he just goes for Magma Storm. So I think the Thorn is gonna switch out here, scouting for Earth Power, because I don't think the Thorn is packing Earth Power himself. But yeah, Elkhorn's might also switch out into exactly into Landorus, because he's paralyzed and he's fearing the Earth Power. So yeah, at first I said the Thorn should switch out and scout for Earth Power. That was because I thought he might not be packing Earth Power, just because he didn't bring in his Heatran on the opposing Heatran earlier when it was paralyzed. But Elkhorn's obviously had to feed the Earth Power more because he was paralyzed and slower. So he can go for a U-turn, he make an aggressive play, or he can go for his rocks, okay. But if the Zapdos has defog, Elkhorn's just lost a lot of momentum. Like, if he went for U-turn, he would have had some offensive momentum on his side and he could have brought in his Tapu Koko again. Because if this has defog now, he's just gonna get rid of all the hazards, but it's fast HPS Zapdos, which is what I was thinking earlier, that it's offensive, because the U-turn from the, I think it was from Tapu Koko earlier, it did like 13 or 10%, it did like a good amount, so I was definitely thinking this is some sort of offensive Zapdos. So it's probably just 3 attacks, and the Lati is gonna be a defog user, so it's gonna be Heatwave, HPS Roost, and Discharge Zapdos, I assume. And yeah, pressure is still really nice, even if you don't have defog. It can help out a lot in balance versus balance matchups to like have more PP than the opponent. But yeah, the Zapdos being poisoned is obviously really bad for the Thorn. The Thorn, oh my lord, he makes an over prediction there. He just clicks rocks again. So basically he was willing to Psychus Landorus there, and in case the Thorn had went for defog there, I think he just clicked rocks in. So he just gets up some hazards in case he had defog, but I'm pretty sure it doesn't have defog. He brings in his Latios on the top as Elkhorn's goes in the Koko, gets off the Scarf defog as U-turn doesn't do much. So the Thorn got rid of all the hazards and he gets a free switch into Elkhorn's gets a free switch into Morwell here, and he can go for Thunder Punch in Electric Terrain. As the Thorn is locked into defog, so he's not gonna be staying in here. And I don't think he wants to go into Gastrodon on a potential play rough, because that will take like 60-70%. That's just my head calc. It will take a lot, basically, because Gastrodon wants Spadef in this meta. So either has to sack something, or I think he's just sacking his type of bullet. Did he predict the Thunder Punch? There's a knockoff. Oh my lord. If the Thorn looks like a god now, if he has like the superpower to do good damage to Morwell. Well, nice nickname by the way for Jan Fuca. He just knocks off again. Really smart play by Alcantz, knowing that he was probably just using the type of bullet to pivot out and to heat turn on a player off. I might have fallen for that, but he just was pretty smart. And he did not fall for the bait. So he can just click Memory Storm here, but he gets up his rocks first. That also makes sense, obviously. But Magma Storm, in case the Landers is like coming out there, if he's not faster than the Landers, that also would have made some sense to me. Like, he didn't have good switches to Magma Storm, to Heatran at all, because, like, just to Heatran in general, he already showed that he had Earth Power, if I recall correctly. So, like, this Alcantz wasn't risking his own Heatran there. So, the Ladi can potentially threaten this Heatran with a trick, because that would be annoying for the Sol losing his lefties. So, I can see him going out into his Tyranitar here, because it's probably Mega Tar, it can't get tricked. And if the Ladi goes for... Oh, it goes for Healing Wish instead of Defog. I mean, yeah, defogging didn't really do much for him, because the Trent could have just set the rocks back up. So he brings his Greninja back, gets up another spike. Smart play, just going for spikes, because Gastrodon has Water Absorb, so you obviously don't want to go for a Water move. And Dark Pulse just bounces off Gastrodon. The only way you beat Gastrodon with Greninja in your regular form is you have to get flinches to get your Ash form. So that's not like what a smart player would do. A smart player sets up the spike there, so that was well played. And he's pretty much free to click Scald here. If he's fearing the Greninja, like if he doesn't want the Greninja to get up multiple spikes for free, you can also just go for Earthquake or Earthpower, depending on what he has. But yeah, Alcantz doesn't have good switch-ins at all. Goes on Tapu Koko, and if he goes for Earthpower, Scald, this should just kill. Goes for Scald, picks up the Tapu Koko. So Tapu Koko was just a nuisance with Nature's Madness spam. Like, it wasn't really like a biggest threat, but it was definitely a bit annoying for the Thorn. So it's looking good for him. He got rid of that, as he's willing to sack off his Tapu Bulu here, as it's not going to be doing too much to the Morwell. Like, the best move it might have is like Z Superpower, but even that won't do that much. It might do like 50 or 60, because Mega Morwell has like decent defense or decent bulk overall. I can see, I don't think Sucker Punch kills. Actually, Sucker Punch might kill because Morwell is really strong, but I don't think Alcantz loses much from clicking Plera as long as he hits. I don't think there's a Wald, or like, I don't think the Thorn is ever going out in the Heatran here. He has basically decided I'm sacking this type of Wood, is what I'm thinking at least. But yeah, I'm liking this game already. It's not going to be that long. We already have like 2 months down. Alcantz get up his SD, so he's like willing, he's like wanting to get a kill. He goes for sub breaking a Sucker Punch, so it's probably sub SD. The last sub SD Tapu Bulu I've seen was actually, oh my lord, Alcantz the god. Did you guys see that? He didn't go for Sucker at first, and then he went for Sucker. I mean, it makes a lot of sense, because he was out of range where he could have made another substitute, but he could have substituted again breaking the Sucker Punch, and then he could have made another substitute. So I'm thinking that he was in range to die from a Sucker Punch at the 40% range where he was at when he subbed, because otherwise he probably would have just attacked him, right? Yeah, what I just wanted to say earlier, the last time I've seen a sub SD bully use was by Alcantz himself, actually, which is funny because now his opponent has one, and it was in Smogtress versus Bengane, was sub SD with Z Superpower, if I recall correctly. So he just goes for Healing Wish, which was pretty obvious there, because he wasn't gonna allow to die, he wasn't gonna allow to get bopped by a Sucker Punch. Like, he wasn't gonna sack off his Ladi for nothing. He was obviously going for Healing Wish. He's fast Heatran, he knows the Landers is slower than his Heatran from the damage that his Tapu Bulu did with Horn Leech. He probably cocked that and then he figured it out. So he gets rid of the Landers there. And the Greninja is gonna be clicking Dark Pulse here. Dark Pulse or Spikes, but probably Dark Pulse. And Alcantz is gonna have to go for flinches on the Gastrodon. The Thorn can also go into his Tyranitar if he breaks the Dark Pulse. But Tyranitar kind of wins this game, so he might not want to risk that. Like, the Gastrodon is just a safe play, but it's pretty obvious that he doesn't want to go for a water move because you have that Gastrodon. So I would have gone into Tita there potentially. Because yeah, he was either going for Spike or he's going for Dark Pulse. He was not going for Hydro Pump. So if he went into Tita there, he would have gotten a free Dragon Lance. I think he could have just swept. I don't think it makes a difference in the end game though. Because now he knows the Greninja was locked in the spikes. And if he goes in the Heatran, that's fine, because the Heatran is paralyzed. I don't remember if we have seen any moves from his Heatran. I can't really hover over to see. I think it was Magma Storm 20, just Drag Dances up. He gets the full parade, and if he Drag Dances again, I don't know if he even has to Drag Dance again. This Tyranta is probably just gonna win the game for the Thorn. Really cool to put Tyranta put in some. Really cool to see Tyranta put in some work at the end here. I mean, it didn't come out yet, but like I'm just thinking about which ones I should put in the thumbnail. I think he can just go for Stone Age here. I think Tyranitar might be able to outspeed Greninja at plus one, it should be. Yeah, this is kind of embarrassing that I don't know it. I mean, it's not embarrassing, but like, yeah, I was pretty sure that you only need one Dragon Dance to outspeed Greninja. For Ash Greninja, you probably need two, but for regular Greninja, I think you just need one. Because I just remember from when I used it, Mega Tita and Auras that you have to run Jolly to outspeed the Tornadus after one Dragon Dance. And it's like Greninja is like about the same speed, it's like a little bit faster if I recall correctly than Torn. It's actually really weird that I don't remember the speed here, but I think Greninja is just a little bit faster than Torn, right? It should be. So I was thinking that it was in the same range, same speed here, kind of. So I was pretty sure that one Dragon Dance is enough to outspeed the Greninja, and like Greninja obviously can't kill a Tyranitar with Water Shuriken because it's really bulky, so like maybe if he gets 5 hits he could kill it with Water Shuriken, but he's gonna go Morwall, and if this has this might be able to live a Fire Punch. I haven't really seen, yeah exactly, he's able to eat a Fire Punch and he gets rid of the Tita with a Play Rough. What I was about to say is I haven't really seen Mega Tita carry off quick, so I was pretty sure that Alcantz could live a hit. But yeah, Heatran can just go for off power here. It's out of range from Sucker Punch. I don't think a crit would kill even. Pretty sure a crit wouldn't kill. Like, I think Sucker Punch will do around like 40 maybe? It does 38, okay. I said 40. They call me the Head Kulk Master. I was only 2% off. And here he's gonna go get Greninja, and his only way of winning is spamming Dark Pulse. He can't go for a water move because of the Gastrodon having a Storm Drain, which is not affected by water moves. It will actually give it a plus one in special attack if you go for a water move. So he has to go for Dark Pulse and flinch the Gastrodon down. Zapdos might also be able to live a hit. I forgot how healthy Zapdos is, but it should. It might actually be around health. He goes actually hard into Gastrodon. And he goes for Hydro Pump. I don't know why Hydro Pump was ever the play there. Unless he's not Specs. He's not Specs, okay. I did not expect that. So maybe he's Z-move Greninja. That's weird. Okay, if you're not Specs, that makes sense that you go for the water move first, because you would have gotten off the Ash one, but he doesn't get the flinch that he needs. He actually needed two flinches in a row there. So I don't think he was getting that off. That was like highly in the Thorn's favor, and Gastrodon picks up the win. Okay, that was really weird. Did he ever show a Z-move this entire game? I don't remember. I don't think he did, so he was probably Z-Hydro Vortex or something. But yeah, good game to the Thorn and Alcantz. Hope you guys all enjoyed. Thank you for watching. And so the score is 2-0 for Europe after this game. But they have actually played two more games after this. That I will go to the Smogon forums now and show you guys the score, because I have not recorded those games. Because I think they were in like lower tiers. No, older gens, that's why I didn't record them live, because I don't really have knowledge about those. So yeah, let me pause and I'll see you there. Yeah, as you guys can see here, the matchup between Latin America and Europe. It says 0-3 here. The Thorn one was Alcantz, you just saw that. Then Breezy Quinks won ADV and Coleo won GSC. And Void just played versus Night Fox in DPP, and Void won the game. Void actually went 4-0, he went 3-0 in the first round, and now he won again. And Europe is 4-0 too. So Europe only has to win two more games. Yeah, it's 10 games overall. So whoever wins 6 games moves on to the next series, to the next round, which is like semi-finals if I'm not mistaken, because there's 8 teams in at the 8 teams left, and 4 teams move on to the next round. And yeah, Europe is looking really good. They are up 4-0. And Latin America has to win like at least 5 of the upcoming 6 games to make it 5-5. I don't know if what happens if you're 5-5. I think we'll get like a tiebreaker where we would play like 3 more games. And probably the team that is a higher seed, which is Latin America, they have a higher seed. Well, they were 2nd, Europe only was 7th, so that's crazy that they're up 4-0. But yeah, we have some really cool games coming up. Femin versus Ricardo, Gondro versus Pearl, Dennis EG vs Black Oblivion. Dennis EG hasn't played so far this World Cup, I'm pretty hyped for this. And yeah, what else? I think I forgot something that I wanted to say. So yeah, basically, I think, I don't know if I explained it, but I think the team that is like the highest seed with Latin America, they're gonna get to pick, if it comes down to a 5-5, they're gonna get to pick which tier will be played in two games, I think. I think this is pretty much how it works. There's gonna be like this, there's like a tie-rack for the 15th and 16th place for the next tier between Asia and Oceania, and you guys can see it's three games over here. So I think that's the same what happens if there's a tiebreaker between any of these other countries. I think it will be three games. And you guys can see it's two Sun and Moon and one GSC game. So I think that the team with the highest seed can pick which gen will be played two games, and the other team will probably... I don't know if the other gen is random or if the other team gets to pick the other gen. I'm not 100% sure about this, but that's just what I assume. I'm somewhat sure, but not 100%. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. We'll see you later with a lot more World Cup coverage. It's gonna be World Cup Sunday. It's gonna be so wild. There's gonna be so many games. And between Germany and US East, there's like 8 games left. And it's 2-0 for Germany at the moment. I'm pretty hyped. But I'm also scared that Germany will lose, because I really hope Germany can beat US East. Let me show you guys the score here. US East vs Germany 2-0 at the moment. But yeah, Brofist versus ICT later on. It's gonna be scary, man. And X-Ray playing DPP. So basically, I haven't slept yet, by the way. It's like early in the morning. I'm gonna like maybe get some guests later on in these recordings, because I might not be able to fully concentrate, because I was up late. Like, I think the last game that I recorded was like at 2 a.m. And yeah, this game I just recorded, it's now like 7 in the morning. I just recorded it because yesterday I didn't get time to record it live. I just saw it happened on my phone, so I ran through my laptop, clicked start recording and left again, because I had to help someone out. I already mentioned this a few times. I don't know why I'm still talking about this. But thank you guys for watching. Hope you all enjoyed. And yeah, let me know if you have like a specific favorite that you want to see that should join the recordings later on. I can give you guys some examples. We have Padlab on my channel sometimes. We have Barrows the Best, aka BTB. He's kind of known on Smogon. He has been building a lot of teams for World Cup. And we have user I'm so sorry lol. We have Count, aka Countryario. He has been in some of my recordings. I don't know. Who else do we have? Oh, I recorded once with Brofist in for SPL, but his own team is going to be playing a lot today, so I don't think he's willing to join a recording today. But in general, I will ask him again. He has a lot of knowledge. He's really good, so that was definitely fun recording with him. But it's also kind of weird recording with people like him, because they're like well known on Smogon, and I'm like kind of a random, so it's like I'm kind of nervous if I record with like people like him. It's funny if he's gonna be watching. This is probably funny for him. But yeah, I'm just pretty hyped for the matchups later. Just let me know, like I said, if you have any of the favorites that you want to see in a recording. I probably forgot someone. Oh yeah, also Super AKA Eric. If you want to see him, let me know. Who else? Yeah, Sabella asked me. I might record with Sabella too. I think it was Sabella. I hope I didn't mix you up. The guy who messaged me on Discord. I haven't recorded with NJMP in a while, but like NJMP is another example. It's just a dude who's like known on Smogon somewhat, and I'm kind of just like a random, so it's like I kind of get nervous when I record with these type of people. It's funny, man, but like I'm fine with it. Like, I have no problem mentioning this. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you later. And just let me know who you want, if you want anyone specific to join the recording. And peace out. Whew. World Cup Sunday gonna be lit. Stay tuned for the coverage. Obviously gonna be focusing on Sun, Moon, OU and RS, and I might record Porsche's game for Black and White later on, as Porsche's gonna be one of the guys from Latin America who's trying to bring it back for his team, so it's gonna be hyped. But yeah, I'm obviously mainly hyped for Germany vs East, and I really hope Germany can win. I'm talking too much. Peace out, friends. Hope you guys all enjoyed the World Cup Sunday coverage. Bob.